Pastor, welcome you guys. Good morning, God. Our research seminar today is timely as it coincides with the nationwide observance of the National Disaster Resilience Month this July. I know that as members of the academy, government, and civil society, you have your own activities lined up for this month-long event. And I noted that we have guests coming from OECD, also UNDP, and other government and donor institutions. On this note, I would like to thank you all for coming here to PIDS to join us for a seminar on disaster risk reduction and management. And the title here is very appropriate, especially in view of the recent earthquake in late. We commiserate, of course, with our Cagayans there. Have we institutionalized DRM in the Philippines? Presented by Dr. Sonny Domingo. The Philippines, with its location in the typhoon belt on the western segment of the Pacific Ocean, Ring of Fire, is vulnerable to disaster, as we all know. Annually, we are visited by an average of 20 typhoons, as well as earthquakes, the latest of which is in Lake, as I mentioned, the magnitude of 6.5. Based on the World Disaster Report 2014, and the Global Climate Risk Index 2014 report respectively, the Philippines ranked as second most affected in terms of weather-related losses and second most disaster-prone among 171 countries in the world. When we come around the region, people sometimes ask us, why would you care to live in the Philippines now after learning that yes, we are second most affected in terms of weather-related losses and second most disaster-prone among 171 countries. And I am quick to add that we are the fourth rank in terms of disasters brought about by politicians. I'm not sure. The taxonomy. Sometimes people view politicians as disasters, but no, they're not. They can be a force for good as well now. We can only say that here in PIDS, not outside. I cannot resist this kind of quipsing, so I might lose my job tomorrow. Okay. Apart from the cost on human lives, the Philippines incurs massive economic losses from disasters. Based on data from 2005 to 2014, it had lost an average of $1.6 billion. Quite a lot of money, equivalent to around 80 billion pesos. So think of what you could have done with 80 billion pesos had that day been lost to disasters. Considering this reality, an effective disaster management scheme must be given high priority. That's why Sonny chose this field. The enactment of the Philippine DRR Act in 2010 is a big leap to mainstream disaster management in the country. The proper implementation, however, is a different story. One of the key areas that government should look into is the existing structure and functions of agencies involved in the whole DRRM operation in the country. For one, it is important to establish seamless coordination and institutional arrangements between and among line agencies and other stakeholders the implementation of disaster-related programs and initiatives. With the huge amount that we spend following a disaster, we also need to look at how our disaster funds are being used and managed. Do we have enough or do we need more? More importantly, are we using them efficiently by prioritizing those who are really in need? As the primary policy think tank in the country, PIDS's duty is to help policymakers in formulating effective and evidence-based policies on how to improve DRRM in this case, with the ultimate goal of saving more lives and properties from calamities. Let me take this opportunity to thank our senior research fellow, Dr. Sonny Domingo, who will shed more light on these matters as he presents his study on the institutionalization of disaster preparedness and management in the country. By the end of the seminar, I hope that you will be able to take away new learnings and participate actively in the discussions. And thank you for coming to the seminar. We hope to have a very lively interaction. And thanks to Wayne who prepared these opening remarks. My task is easy, just to read opening remarks.